This problem is asked that we draw on an internal energy volume diagram a curve that approximately represents a reversible adiabatic expansion of an ideal gas. And then we want to label on that same diagram, what is the area that corresponds to all irreversible adiabatic expansions from that same starting point to the same final volume? So first, let's look at a drawing. So as we, for example, take an ideal gas and compress it and decrease its volume, we do that adiabatically, we increase its temperature. And since delta U is CV delta T for an ideal gas, that means we increased internal energy. So we have some sort of curve that looks like this. The exact details don't matter. Now this says expansion, so that means we're going to start here and we're going to expand. So we're going to go in this direction. It's reversible, so the same reasoning applies whether it's expansion or compression. We expand, we take energy out, we lower the internal energy because we're doing work. So this is a reversible case. Now the question is, what happens if we do this irreversibly? Well, if we expand irreversibly, we're going to get less work out of the system, which means the internal energy is going to decrease less. So that means to get to the same final volume, we'd have curves that look like this. And the extreme, of course, would be where we got no work out of the system. So anything in this area would correspond to irreversible adiabatic process for expansion. Can't have the energy be higher since we're not adding any energy, but if we take out less energy as work, then we have a smaller decrease in temperature. We can't get below this line for irreversible adiabatic process, because getting below this line would say we took out more work than for reversible process.